So now let's go to the second most important, the second strongest, and that's going to be called the dipole-dipole force, or what I like to call the net dipole force. Why? Because if you know how to draw dipoles, and if you know how to find net dipoles, that's all you need for this. So for example, a molecule like acetone, which is one that I brought up earlier in our lessons, acetone looks like this. Does it have a dipole? Yes, it does. It actually has several dipole moments. It would have dipole moments pulling this way and this way because of the lone pairs, and it would have a major dipole moment pulling that way because of the double bond. But overall, we would just say that it has basically a partial negative up here and a partial positive down here. Does that make sense so far? Because basically, what's going to end up happening is that I'm just going to get a big dipole pulling electrons. Oops. I'm going to get a big dipole pulling electrons towards the O. Okay, so I'm going to get a partial negative and a partial positive. Okay, remember that we use the lowercase delta to represent partial. And it means that I don't know exactly what the number is, I just know that it's more than the other. Okay, we'll check out what can happen. When I have a net dipole, another acetone molecule can arrange itself so that the partial negative from one of the molecules orients with the partial positive of the other. And by that, in that way, they wind up sticking together. And you can imagine that I could have a bunch of acetone molecules all neatly arranged so that all the negatives link with all the positives. Okay? This is only possible, though, if you have a net dipole. If there's no net dipole, then you're not going to be able to form this force. Does that make sense? So this is what we call the second strongest force. It's not quite as strong as hydrogen bonding, but it still is a pretty strong force.